Okay.
Rotate the oven 90 degrees clockwise and the lid 90 degrees counterclockwise. But this one's a 12 inch.
Okay. Go ahead. You missed her. I usually close the screen door and let Yuna watch, and she'll sneak her paw out to try to keep the door open. I know what you're doing.
Apparently, neighbor time, which is something we do every day since the beginning of quarantine, so basically since we moved in, the house next door, on both sides, and the house across the street, we all hang out. I'm just gonna call them the neighbors. Those are the houses I'm referring to. And we sit out in our lawns, in our lawn chairs, chill out. The kids play soccer, they ride bikes. And today is actually a special Sunday fun day. There is a peach cobbler being made in a Dutch oven that was recently purchased by my neighbor at Walmart for $17. And we all wanted to make something, and it was a peach cobbler. So I went and grabbed the peaches last night, dropped them off. So we're very excited about that, but I have snuck in to do the dishes because it's a total tragedy. It's Sunday, so it's cleaning, get this house back in order day, pick up day, reset day. You guys know what I mean. What else you gonna do on a Sunday, right? Greetings and salutations. I thought I could do some sort of little home vlog for you guys, summer vlog, update you on little things around the house, some office progress, and just, you know, things that have been going on for the month of July. But first, we gotta get this together because I just woke up and this is fresh out the bed. There was a long travel day yesterday and we'll get into that soon. But let's get into the skin first. Today I'm going to be using products from Medicube, who were nice enough to sponsor today's video, and we are also going to be doing a giveaway, so stay tuned for those details.
If you haven't heard of Medicube, they are Korea's number one dermocosmetic skincare brand. They have a product for every single skin concern. Today I'm using their 5-piece collagen booster set for that popular glass skin look. If you're interested in purchasing this set yourself, you can get it for $80 using my code SAM15 for 15% off, and I'll have it linked off at the top of the info box. I'm going to cleanse using their Zero Foam Cleanser. A little bit goes a long way, and it's very rich and bouncy. A pro tip is that it's great with your fingers, but you can use it with the dual cleansing pore brush and the foam gets even richer. It feels so good. It's effective, but still gentle enough for sensitive skin. Next up, I'll be using the Zero Pore Pads as my last step of cleansing. The packaging's pretty cool. After you remove the inner cap, there's a pair of tweezers for you to grab a pad and keep them sanitary. The hydrating pads are dual-sided, and there's a texture emboss side, which is what I start with for extra exfoliation, and I finish with the smooth side. Another pro tip, if you put these in the fridge, they also make a great DIY cool pack for the summer. Step 3 is the Glass Glow Essence 2.0. Their entire Glass Glow line feels amazing, and the rose gold packaging is gorgeous. The essence is fast absorbing, and I'm just going to pat it in. When you pair this with the Glass Glow Serum 2.0, it gives you a lasting glow. The soft texture of the gel is so refreshing, and this combo makes a great base for makeup. Last but not least, the Triple Deep Erasing Cream locks in all the moisture and all the goodness. This rich texture is good as a day cream, but if you use it as a night treatment, the collagen, elastin, and hyaluronic acid will have you waking up with that smooth goodness. As you guys can see, my skin really enjoys all of these products. If I had to pick a favorite, the Glass Glow Serum 2.0 easily takes you from dull and dry to hydrated and glowy. Glowy skin's always in, but especially during summertime, and my makeup lays amazing over this set.
Before we discuss our giveaway details, let me go fix all of this and all of this, and I'll be right back. Much better. Hair done, face on. I did a really quick little summer beat and threw on some comfy shorts and a tank, and I'm ready for thy day. But let's talk about this giveaway before we get going. So for this giveaway, we'll be having 10 winners, and you will receive one Medicube Blue Erasing Cream and the Medicube Blue Erasing Cream in the rich formula. Both of these are soothing creams to help calm your skin after any irritation or any exposure to any sort of harmful things to your skin barrier. This helps repair it. The rich formula, of course, is just more moisturizing, but you'll be receiving both if you're one of the 10 lucky winners. To enter this giveaway, make sure you comment on this video, leave me a social media handle of some sort so I can contact you if you win, and all winners will be picked by random generator. If you've tried or heard of Medicube products before, then let me know down below why you love their brand, and if you have not tried their product before, let me know why you're interested in trying out their brand. And make sure you include hashtag Medicube and hashtag I love Medicube in your comments to have a valid entry. And don't forget to take advantage of my discount code Sam15. Now it's about time for me to go about my day. We need to go pick up some seafood because we're gonna do a seafood outdoor social distancing feast. A little excited, very casual. We are in charge of picking up the seafood, so let's get to going.
So I'm not really making a tutorial, but I took some clips of when I was making the Thai seafood sauce, also known as nam chim, and for Laos, I think it's known as jiao, and I'll leave the recipe down below. The only thing I kind of went random with is that I had some old onion in my fridge and I just threw that in. I typically don't do that, but it's a sauce customized kind of to taste. It is salty, but also an underlying of sweetness from the sugar. I love a good amount of garlic and peppers in it, and it's amazing with almost anything, but especially seafood. So check out the link down below. After 2 hours of seafood, the kids all went to bed and the moms all came back out, as you can see me here from my security footage. And we sat out and had a mom's happy hour, which we do sometimes in our lawn chairs. We just chat, we drink, we chill. And we did that to almost 2 a.m. So it was a good time. I also wanted to show you guys some vacation footage from a 2-night stay. We stayed in Corolla, North Carolina, in the Outer Banks area. It was my first time there, but it's a house that Chris's family frequently rents out because they know the person who owns it. And we just had some good old family time. We spent like an hour or something at the beach one day, but the rest of the time we spent in the pool on the property, and just a lot of good chill vibes.
As you may have seen earlier in the vlog, we did a Dutch oven peach cobbler with our neighbor last weekend, and it may be 11:40 at night right now, and we may have a peach cobbler in the oven. It may not be in a Dutch oven. It's actually looking really good. I get so nervous cooking in any of the Pyrexes. This is one of the ones that you can only put in if the oven's already preheated, which makes sense, but for me, I get really nervous in any sort of glassware, bakeware. So, rare occasion. I've made chicken in it before. And honestly, it looks very similar to the Dutch oven, except for less of the burnt edges. There are still like caramelized sugar edges, which I do really like, because they give this like creme brulee-ish type of, you know, burnt sweetness. So I'm gonna end my night eating some of this peach cobbler and maybe some mint chocolate chip ice cream. Yeah, that's the kind of week I am having. But we also went to Home Goods and I got a few good finds. Spent about $60 and it was not bad at all. 60 well spent dollars. So I'm gonna show you guys that in the morning when we got some good lighting. Who wants to see home decor in bad lighting, right? And we're back. I'm a little bit more dolled up than I was a second ago. Just a little bit. We did some filming today. See our front door right there, and this is our entryway. It's not really an entryway because there's a closet right here, and this is just my wannabe foyer set up, as you guys have seen before with the mirror and the shoes. If we didn't have a lot of shoes, I totally would do more of a open table, like a dual level table. Can't really do that. We got a lot of shoes. We have a new basket. We're trying her out. The tag is still on. She's from Tarjay. I saw her all by her lonesome and I thought, I give her a go. She's pretty well finished on the inside. You can see there's actually a package in here, and that's what I wanted it for. I thought it'd be a nice place to just put our packages in as they come in, because yes, first world problems, I get lots of packages, as you see. I'm not sure if she's it yet. I'm warming up to her. I don't really know, but typically she's on the other side of the shelf around here. So when we're out of town, our neighbors can just toss any packages into this little basket. But for the sake of balance, we're just gonna let her sit here for the rest of this clip. Ignore the phone tripod. She's set up to do our like B-roll. So I got this basket and I'm a pretty big fan of her. The only problem is she was all by her lonesome as well. So this is for my closet, because at the top of my office closet, which is basically my new makeup storage, I got a pack system from IKEA. I have shelves where I would like to put, you know, things I'm collecting for mystery box giveaways or things that I'm planning to record with, but I need it to be organized and I have spaces for packages too. So I want to do at least one row of bins going this way. There's a lot of stuff in here right now, so it's kind of wider than usual. The price is way better at Home Goods than Amazon when it comes to these bins, though I saw very similar things on both stores. This was $10. This was not part of the purchase. Chris decided to buy loofahs for $3, but he liked the dual colored loofah. You know, not for you, honey. I bought these little white wood, beige wood, grayish white wood tables, which I don't know how I feel about yet, but you can use them separately. There's some foam on the inside right now to keep them from scratching each other. And this was $15 for both. They also had circular wooden ones, but I like the beads because I have some decorative beads that are wooden in the same tone that I thought would look good on this table. So maybe set one up there. I don't know, maybe the other one would go into my office or maybe even the bedroom. Then last but not least is this wood wicked candle. Very, very cute. Comes with this little stand, has little wood feet and more of a concrete bottom. It has the brand name, which is Maker's Wax Goods. So the base has like MWG. And this is juniper, gin, and citrus. And it was $10, I believe. Yes, $10. I adore woodwick candles, as I'm sure many of you guys do too. I'm not trying to put too many gray tones because I want to get vases for the right corner of the table. I just haven't found vases I like yet, so I'm probably gonna end up buying some affordable ones and just spraying them when I find like the shape I like. Now that the basket's empty, you can kind of get a little peek of what it's supposed to look like. It's more this shape, and I thought I could do three. It's very soft and not scratchy, which is what I like about it. And there was plenty of just the white braided baskets, white throughout, but I thought that was kind of plain and maybe this would give a little texture to the office closet since the closet itself is already white. And I almost forgot, because I was sitting on it, I got the step stool. So this is a Ray Dunn step stool, I believe, and it actually says step up on the top. I thought this would be perfect for my office. I'm probably gonna clear coat the top, though it is pretty sanded and pretty finished. I'm gonna clear coat just so I don't end up with splinters or like messing it up, and that should be pretty easy. It's very sturdy and holds up to 250 pounds. Honestly, I really like her for usage. As you can see, she is very sturdy, so I can reach the top of my closet and the higher bins, but also a great piece for when I'm sitting and recording. This kind of works as a footrest for me because it's lower than the stool that I'm sitting on, and that really helps with my sciatica. And then from Amazon, I picked up two books for decor to put on this table, but also books I really want to read. So these are based off of home decor. It's the Homebody book from Joanna Gaines from Magnolia Farms. She makes a bunch of different books, you know, Magnolia Tables, like the cooking version, but this one is more a guide to creating spaces you'll never want to leave. I like the stem that says Homebody, so that's what you'd mainly see, filled with different inspo and inspiration. Second book is Monochromatic Home. Pretty self-explanatory. The stem is a different color, so I thought that would give nice dimension. This is good information, but also a lot of visual inspo.
Our entryway table went through a transformation within 2 weeks depending on what arrived, and I kept moving things around so that I finally got it to its final form, which is in the next clip right here, because my pompa grass arrived and I love it. Details are below.
An area I didn't talk too much about in my last home update was this area. I did mention that we put a single black curtain rod. We have a double on the other window, and I got this curtain. I thought I'd give you guys up close where it's more of a white color, honestly. There's a little bit of a like off-white to it, but for the most part, when the light shines on it, it looks white, and it has a dark gray stitching to it. Not our forever curtains, but definitely good for the meantime. I really like them. I'm thinking about adding a second one because I do feel like it is weird with one, but having the second means one's always going to be closed because this is a sliding door that only opens from one side. This is Yuna's section because her bowls are on the floor, and her bowls actually match the Ray Dunn step stool I have because they are Ray Dunn dog bowls from Home Goods, but she's had those for a while, so I'm technically just jocking her style. And we have these black modern hooks for her stuff. She has way too many leashes right now, that's why it looks overpacked, but typically she'd only have one leash on in her harness.
It's raining right now. Before the area behind the door, I do want to put the same hooks that we have for Yuna's harness, these black square metal ones, and put maybe like five across the wall just for guests to hang their coats, since ours are in the closet itself. The main addition that I see every day is our new gallery wall. I mentioned to you guys that I wanted to add this above the couch. I did two rows of four, and I think it fits the space pretty well. I got the prints done online from Nations Photo Lab, which is a Maryland-based company that my sister-in-law has used before, so she recommended them to me, and I turned the photos black and white myself using just Pick Monkey, honestly. They're probably gonna be replaced whenever we can do another updated family photo shoot. Well, some of them will be replaced, not all. But temporarily, we got some snowboarding pictures, we got a baby Yuna picture, of course some wedding shots, and of course the kiddos, different experiences, and I try to keep them pretty balanced. The frames themselves are IKEA. Very affordable way to do a gallery wall. I think the frames are $10 each, so $80 for the frame. They are a little bit more difficult to hang because they are the Ribba frames, and they are very deep set, so look those up before you commit to those. Kind of the West Elm ones are really easy to mount, but they're very expensive, so we ended up just using longer screws. We've already chatted about this area, but let's talk about the curtains. These curtains I found on Target's website. They are from Scott Living, which I didn't know the Property Brothers had a line, but it's the Property Brothers line, and I like the curtain. The rod itself is the double version, as mentioned earlier, Umbro brand. They're on my Amazon store page. I do like it. We have a little bit of a hole that you guys don't need to look at up close.
Both of my camera batteries died, so sorry guys, had to switch my phone real quick. Anywho, the hole right there is from the previous curtain rod from the previous owner. You guys don't need to look at it up close. I'm gonna patch it, but I wanted to give you guys shots of the curtains. It has a textured paneled look. Stars in a way, depending on how you wanna look at it, or it's just diamonds and shapes, but regardless, it's very abstract, has different textures to it, but it's cream colored. And I like that it was different than the rug, but not too much. But a little something more than solid. You know, I had a really tough time figuring out curtains, and they're pretty affordable. I wanna say they're in like the 40s, and you can get them on Target's website, not in store, sadly.
We're in the midst of a really, really, really bad rainstorm because we haven't had rain in a while, so the lights are flashing. I'm gonna start wrapping this up, y'all.
I also purchased these curtains. We'll see how they look, but these are for the office because I needed thicker curtains for when I'm filming. As you can see, my filming setup from today is still up, and you can get a peek at my IKEA closet that's not set up either. That's where I wanted the bins to be. I don't know what angle is better right now, but bins up here. But back to what I was saying, I need blackout curtains because the light will change on some days too often in a video, and it just affects everything. So it's nice to have that option of just like full studio or open it for full natural. I need to figure out what metal I want for curtain rods because these are not my curtain rods, previous owner's curtain rods, and I'm considering spraying light tarnish gold. I'm thinking light tarnish gold compared to really bright gold, some sort of gold for the rim of this mirror, whatever curtain rod I end up buying, and also the metal bracket for my backdrop switch. Is a new addition. I didn't have that before. Since they're black, they really, really stand out. I figured I could leave it and it matches the rest of my gear, or I could spray it and it'd be a nice statement piece. When you look at this little suitcase that actually came from Stila, and it was part of a PR, it has tarnished gold. So it's not fully gold, it's not fully silver. It's like a nice in between. I kind of like this color. So I'm thinking about doing
that. We'll see how it goes. I can't find a spray paint. I was at Home Depot looking, and there's just like really, really brassy ones, really, really coppery ones. Not exactly sure as I move my recording light. We're gonna figure it out though. And I hope you guys enjoyed this summer vlog, what we've been up to, update. It's dark, it's gloomy, the rain is intense, so I think this is a good note for me to say thank you guys so much for watching. My recent uploads will be on the screen if you're interested in checking those out, and I will leave as much information as possible. Don't forget to enter the giveaway. It's only up for 2 weeks, so take advantage. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing glimpses of the office and seeing the changes around the house and what I recently hauled. Y'all know for a fact, while I'm searching Home Goods for more of those bins, I'm gonna find another find. So make sure you stay tuned for those. That's it for me today. I'll see you guys in a later video.